In this video, I'm going to show you how to get from this photo to this photo in just 4 clicks using AI in Lightroom. My name is Brian Matias. If you're new here, welcome. I'm a photo educator who helps photographers like you improve the look of your landscape and travel photos using apps like Lightroom and Photoshop and other third-party apps as well. Now, in addition to showing you how I get this photo in just 4 clicks to look so much better, I'm also going to show you how to build your own AI adaptive presets in Adobe Lightroom, and it's freaking awesome. So let's get started. So here's this photo that I took at Death Valley National Park a few years ago, and as you can see, it's got a pretty strong color cast. So my first click will be to get a custom white balance. To do that, I'm going to press W on the keyboard to bring up the white balance dropper, and I'm just going to click over here. You can see how it gets rid of that color cast. Now, technically pressing the W on my keyboard, okay, you know, it's not a click, it's a keyboard press, so don't hold that against me. But first click is the custom white balance. Second click is going to be getting this image to look kind of evenly exposed. And the way that I'm going to do that is just by clicking on auto. Now, don't feel badly about using auto. This auto button is really good and I see absolutely nothing wrong with it. So it's just an easy way, one click way to get you to a good evenly exposed place and you can refine from here. So got the image here. That was my second click. Third click is I'm going to use one of my own custom built AI adaptive presets from my landscape AI pack. I'm going to start with the sky only pack over here, and I'm going to select the dramatic sky boost. You can see how that instantly in one click, that was click number 3, improved the look of the sky. And then I'm going to make the foreground match by selecting a preset from my foreground only pack from landscape AI called the moving water enhancer. You can see how that adds a nice contrast boost and it makes the entire image tie together really nicely. And in case you didn't catch that, those two presets were using AI and they were adaptive to this image. What that means is when I applied my sky only preset, it automatically analyzed the image and it applied the mask specifically to the sky. And then when I applied the foreground preset, it analyzed and found the foreground and applied the preset there. So if you were to open up one of your own images and then apply one of my sky or foreground presets, it would actually analyze your image to find the sky in the foreground. So it would adapt to your photo, which is what makes these AI presets so powerful. So let's continue. And now I want to show you how to build your own AI adaptive presets in Lightroom. First things first, let's go ahead here. I'm just going to collapse these categories, and then I'm going to click reset to start over. And just like before, I'm going to press W to get a custom white balance and click on auto. Now, before I do anything when it comes to building my presets, I mentioned how I want to get the image to look evenly exposed. What that means is I don't recommend using any of these sliders here. Basically, you don't want to stylize your image at this point. In fact, I'm going to double click these slider headers over here to restore them back to 0. And I also want to make sure that things like texture, clarity, and dehaze are set to 0. The only sliders you really kind of want to work with before you start building your presets are white balance, so temperature and tint, as well as these 6 sliders here under tone. And the reason for that is typically I use my presets to stylize. So if I'm already stylizing by adding, say, you know, dehaze and clarity, and then I apply a preset on top of this, it's going to compound and it's just going to make it look really kind of over the top. So again, start by working with these sliders here and get your image to kind of a nice, evenly exposed look. And it's also important to remember that what's evenly exposed for this image will probably be different for another image in different lighting conditions and different subject matter. So just keep that in mind. So what I mean by that is, like, maybe, you know, let the highlights be open a little bit more, you know, maybe don't open the shadows that much as it would, again, because auto is analyzing the image here and it's adjusting these sliders here according to the histogram of this photo. So let's just keep it, if anything, just keep it boring. Like, this is a nice shot, but it's kind of boring. The tones are kind of flat. This is where building presets will help. So the first thing you want to do to build a preset, or rather an AI adaptive preset, is go to the masking panel. And this is what's going to allow you to apply a preset to the specific areas of the sky and foreground of your photo. In the masking panel, we're going to start by clicking on sky. Now, if I hover over the mask over here, And if I look kind of towards the right of the mountain range in the background, you'll see that the mask is kind of spilling over. And you can control the color of the mask by clicking on this little color chip over here and then hovering over. So in order to kind of keep that mask even cleaner, here's what we're going to do. First, I'm going to click on this three dot icon and rename it, and we'll call this sky mask, just to make it easier to identify. I'm then going to click in here, which will reveal the actual mask itself, or rather the selection of the mask. I'm going to click on subtract. Then I'm going to click on select sky again. And you're like, well, that makes no sense. You just undid the selection. That's true. But with the sky 2 here, I'm going to go to the three dots and then I'm going to click on invert. Now, if I hover over, you see how that mask is a lot cleaner? The mountain range isn't selected like it was before. And so now we have a much tighter selection for the sky. And this is going to benefit you with all of your images by doing this. Instead of just selecting sky, making sure you do select sky, then subtract with the inverse of the sky. I know, it's weird, but trust me, it gives you the best possible results. So with the sky mask selected here, now you can go ahead and adjust the look of your preset for the sky specifically. So that can mean maybe dropping exposure and adding a little bit of contrast, maybe cooling it off a little bit and adding a bit of saturation. And then probably my favorite thing for skies is adding some dehaze. And that adds some really nice dramatic look. And then you can see if we toggle that mask, I mean, it just does a beautiful job of adding a punchy look. So now that we've created the mask, now we need to save the preset. To do that, on the left column here, you'll want to make sure you view your presets. If you don't see them, right click and make sure that presets is checked. Then click on this plus icon and select create preset. Now here are a few things that we'll do. First, we'll call this, moody sky. You can call it whatever you want, obviously. The next thing is you'll want to make sure that you categorize your presets that you create into whatever categories you want. In my case, you can see I created groups for the presets for foreground only, for sky only, and for full scene. And I'll talk about this in a second. So what you'll do here is you'll click on the group, click on new group, and call this my AI presets, and then click create. Next, what you'll want to do is click on check none to make sure that nothing is selected here. And then under masking, select that sky mask. The other thing that you'll want to make sure of is under advanced settings that you have the support amount slider enabled. This is super important. I'll talk about this in a minute. So with that, let's click create. And so there you go. There is the category you just created with the mask. So if I go here and I delete this mask, all I need to do is go back here and that mask is right back where it was. Now, before we continue on with building the foreground pack, I just want to take a few seconds to tell you about my landscape AI preset packs. So let's say you're just not interested in building your own presets. You want to get a collection of 30 presets that have been expertly built to give you amazing looks for the skies and foregrounds of your landscape photos across a wide variety of conditions. I definitely recommend you should try out the Landscape AI pack. If you click on the link below, you can learn more about it. And again, I also thank you for your support because that directly helps me continue making these kinds of videos. So again, check it out. The link's in the description below. All right, let's go back to editing. So to recap, we've already gone ahead and we've created our sky mask. You can see it here. Now we want to create a foreground mask because right now the sky's looking really nice, but the foreground is still kind of boring. To do that, we're going to create another mask over here. And again, we're going to select the sky, except this time what we're going to do is we're going to invert it. So let's invert mask one. So now that is just the foreground. But here's the thing. If we hover over, you can see that there's some areas of the clouds that the Adobe AI engine selected. We don't want that. So just like before, kind of like before, we're going to go ahead and this time we're just going to subtract the sky. Now, if we hover over, look at that clean selection. I mean, that's just razor sharp across the horizon, and it's just perfect. And so this will work great for any of your landscape photos. I'm going to go ahead and rename this. We'll call this one foreground mask and click OK. And now we can adjust the foreground. So here, maybe we want to make it just a little bit brighter. It was getting a bit too dark. Let's add some contrast. Let's bump the highlights and add the shadows to create even more contrast. We'll add the same thing with the white point and the black point here. You want to make sure that, you know, your foreground preset complements the sky preset whenever you're pairing them together. So in this case here, they both are kind of punchy and contrasty. And then I can do some things like warm the temperature of the foreground. And typically my foregrounds have texture. So add some texture, add a little bit of clarity. And now you have a foreground mask that really complements the sky. And it's time to save that. So what you can do now is go back here under presets, click the plus icon, create preset. Here we're going to call this foreground mask, or we can call this moody foreground. And then this time what we're going to do is deselect the sky mask and select the foreground mask. Again, making sure the amount slider is enabled. Let's click create. And there is the foreground, just like before. If we delete the foreground mask and then click on it, it comes right back. Now, I mentioned the strength slider, or the amount, enabling the amount support. And that is super important. And I'll show you why right now. Let's jump to a different photo here. I'm going to go to this photo that I took. And you can see that we have, it has not been edited at all. It's basically straight out of camera. So just like before, let's start by applying a sky preset that we just created. So I'm going to hover over this. And you can see that the mask has been dynamically generated for this image. I'm going to click on it. Now you might think, yeah, this is kind of strong for this image. I like the look, but it's kind of strong. That's where the amount slider comes in. Unlike older presets that Lightroom supported, these new AI adaptive presets have an amount slider. So if I go to zero, it's as if there's no sky. If I go to 200, it's Technicolor. We don't like that. So I'm just going to bring it up, you know, probably right around here. 75 looks good. And then if I want, I can go ahead and click on the mask icon, then click on the sky mask, and then I can adjust these sliders however I want. You know, it's however you want to, let's say you want to make the sky a little bit brighter and you want to drop the highlights just a little bit. You can do that. You can tweak the settings however you want. Maybe it's too cool for you, so you can adjust the color temperature. And then if you want, you can create a new preset using the instructions that I just gave. But the point is that the first tool that you have at your disposal is the strength slider, or the amount slider here. Then the other one is being able to refine the settings. So another fantastic ability with the AI adaptive presets that you didn't have with old presets is the ability to stack them. And that's what I showed you before. We applied a preset to the sky. Now we're going to apply a preset to the foreground. You can see how it just does this really nice job of adding a little bit of punchiness. So just like before, let's go and bring the amount to zero and slowly bring it up. And that's looking really good. And you can see how the preset for the sky and the foreground complement each other really, really well. And that's what's involved with creating your own AI adaptive presets for Lightroom. Now, here's an even cooler thing. If you have sync enabled with Creative Cloud, these presets that you create will sync over to Adobe Photoshop, which you can access through the Camera Raw filter. You can use it in the Lightroom desktop app. And even cooler is that it'll sync to your mobile devices as well. So if you're using Lightroom on your iPad or your iPhone or an Android device, as long as you've got that Lightroom app, you'll have access to these presets and they work perfectly. It's really awesome. And so that's why I am so excited about this tool and the creative potential that it offers, because it allows you to get amazing results in a fraction of the time. And speaking of time, if you're just not interested again in just building your own presets, please take a look at the Landscape AI Pack. The link's in the description below. And if you want to see another editing video where I talk about the importance of using HDR when editing a sunset photo, as well as using these AI presets, click on this video here. I hope you found this video helpful, and I look forward to seeing you on the next one. Thanks a lot.